Today we are going to discuss problems of alkyl halides and aryl halides that are asked by JEE Main from 2002 to 2015. We are going to discuss questions one by one of this chapter. The first question that was asked by JEE Main 2003 is question number 1, which states that bottle contains C6H5I and C6H5CH2I. One is phenyl iodide, second is benzyl iodide. Loses their original labels. They were labeled as A and B for testing. A and B were separately taken in test tube. And boiled with NaOH solution. The end solution in each tube was made acidic with dilute HNO3 and then some AgNO3 solution was added. Substance B gave a yellow precipitate. Which of the following statement is true for this experiment? A option is A is C6H5CH2I. I think this is written here. Some C6H5I here. C. Addition of HNO3 was unnecessary. And D option is A is C6H5I. This was the question asked by JEE Main in 2003. You have to see the difference between aryl halides and alkyl halides. C6H5I is an aryl halide, whereas C6H5CH2I will have is an alkyl halides. Now read the question carefully. A and B are separately. We have to determine which one is A and which one is B. Tested with NaOH. Both are taken. A is boiled with NaOH and B is again boiled with NaOH. Both are boiled with NaOH. Boiled. The end solution of each was made acidic and then after HNO3 is added. Then after HNO3 is added, and then some AgNO3 was also added. AgNO3 was added. Substance B gives yellow precipitate. Here you will getting yellow precipitate. About substance B, it is told that substance B is giving yellow precipitate. Yellow precipitate will be certainly of AgI. AgI is yellow. AgCl is white. AgBr is creamy color, and AgI will be yellowish white. So AgI will be the precipitate. It means that this compound here will have free iodide ion. Free iodide ion, that's why it is converting into AgI. If you look at the options given here, C6H5 and C6H3H2I, first you have been told that you have to boil it with, NaOH. So if we boil and with its NaOH, then it is second one will easily give NaI because iodide is free here. From benzyl ring, this one has a structure as follows. From these spaces, iodide can be easily extracted, can be easily removed out. And in this way, you can easily see that B is going to be equal to C6H5CH2I. And A will going to be equal to then C6H5I, from which if you use NaOH to boil it, NaOH boiled, then it will produce C6H5I, and there is almost no reaction in this case. There may be the possibility of reaction of nucleophilic aromatic substitution reaction in presence of NaOH, but here you will have easily reaction of, first of all, if you boil with NaOH, you will get C6H5CH2OH plus NaI. Then after you have added HNO3 dissolve alcohol, and NaI will react with AgNO3 to form AgI. So this is the final answer. A will be the correct answer. In such type of question, you can easily see that aryl halides is less reactive than alkyl halides, and alkyl halides will easily react with NaOH to form this compound. If you use HNO3, then HNO3 will dissolve these two molecule, and after then AgNO3 will produce AgI precipitate with NaI. In first case, if you boil this one compound with NaOH, there is very less possibility of formation of C6H5OH plus NaI because aromatic nucleophilic substitution reaction is very difficult reaction. So the extent of reaction in A case will be less and B case will be high. So A is C6H5I and B is C6H5CH2I. The next question that was asked by the manager, question number 2 was, the compound formed on heating chlorobenzene with chloral in the presence of conch H2SO4 is, A option is freon, B option is DDT, C option is gamaxine, and D option is hexachloroethane. This was the question asked by JV in 2004. The compound is, the question is telling that you have to react chlorobenzene, means it is reacting with chloral, in presence of strong, H2SO4, is strong H2SO4. If you react it with chloral, you will have CCl3CHO. This compound is known as chloral. And if we react it with H2SO4 conch, you will have CCl3CH, and then here we will have this one Cl, and here we will have this one Cl, and this is 1-1-1 trichloro 2-2 bis parachlorophenyl ethane, and its commercial name is DDT. So you can easily see that the correct option will be B, where when chlorobenzene is reacted with chloral, the formation of DDT will occur. The next question is question number 3. Question number 3 is tertiary alkyl halides are practically DDT, practically inert to substitution by SN2 mechanism. Because of A option is a steric hindrance, B option is inductive effect, C option is instability, and D option is insolubility. This was a question asked by JV 2005, and this is a very easy question. SN2 mechanism, you have to see a steric hindrance, and that's why if you look at the tertiary alkyl, you will have very high steric hindrance, nucleophile attack from backside, and where a steric hindrance play a very important role. So this is SN2 mechanism, nucleophile attack from backside, and from backside nucleophilic attack will be occur easily if there is less steric hindrance in tertiary alkyl, where three groups are attached to alpha carbon, nucleophile can't attack easily, and due to a steric hindrance, the possibility of SN2 mechanism on tertiary alkyl halide will be very less. Question number 4. Alkyl halides react with dialkyl copper reagent to give. A option is alkyl halides, B option is alkane, C option is alkyl copper halide, and D option is alkenes. And this was again asked by JV 2005. If you look at the options given, the correct answer will be B, because it is a Cory-Hawes synthesis. RL react with R2Cu in presence of Li, R2Cu Li, dialkyl lithium cuprate, dialkyl lithium cuprate to form RRS. So this is the correct answer. You will have formation of alkane. This reaction is called Cory-Hough synthesis. Dialkyl lithium cuprate. This is the reagent. Dialkyl copper with lithium will produce RRS. Actually, dialkyl copper will source of R minus. And if it is source of R minus, it will attack on RRS and form it RRS. So it is a unsymmetrical alkane. Cory-Hough synthesis is a very good method to prepare any type of alkane, whereas other type of reaction like Wood's reaction only produce symmetrical alkane. So Cory-Hough synthesis is this one if you use lithium with copper 2 plus. Question number 5. Elimination of bromine from 2-bromobutane results in the formation of A option, predominantly 2-butyne. B option is predominantly 1-butene. C option is predominantly 2-butene. And D option is equimolar mixture of 1 and 2-butene. This was the question asked by J-Man again in 2005. If you look at the options, 2-bromobutene, this means CH3CHBr and CH2CH3. If you do elimination reaction here, then there will be formation of CH3CH2CH3 plus CH2 double bond CH2CH3. However, this is major product and this is minor product. Schiedsoff rule tells that elimination, Schiedsoff product will be major product, because Schiedsoff rule tells that elimination product will be major product, which is more substituted because that is more stable. This is more stable and hence the major product that is forming is predominantly 2-butene. 2-butene will be the major product because this is 2-butene, this is 1-butene. So major product will be 2-butene because this is a product. We are following Schiedsoff rule, which says that more substituted alkene will be the major product. More substituted alkene will be the major product because that is more stable. There are 4 rules of elimination reaction: rules of conjugation, Schiedsoff rule, and then after anti-Schiedsoff rule, and then after Hoffman rule. In this case, you have to simply follow Schiedsoff rule. Question number 6. Phenyl magnesium bromide react with methanol to give A option, a mixture of toluene and MgOHBr. B option, a mixture of phenol and MgMeBr. C option, a mixture of anisole and MgOHBr. And D option is a mixture of benzene and MgOMeBr. This was the question asked by JMA 2006. If you react PhMgBr with CH3OH, you must know that in such type of reaction, simply acidic hydrogen will be trapped by pH minus here. So the formation of PhH plus CH3OMgBr will occur. Grignard reagent, this is Grignard reagent, RMgX. And RMgX react with any compound having H plus to form RH. This is the concept. If a compound is able to donate H plus, even weakly, weak acid there are, then also RH is forming. So the correct answer will be D, where it is told that a mixture of benzene and MgOMe and Br is formed. So this is the correct result. Question number 7. Fluorobenzene C6H5F can be synthesized in the laboratory. A, by direct formation of fluorination of benzene and F2 gas. C, B option is by reacting bromobenzene with NaF solution. C option is by heating phenol with HF and KF. And D option is from aniline by diazotization followed by heating the diazonium salt with HBFO. This is the correct result. Last one is, you can remember that the correct option, the correct result, the correct way to form phenyl fluorobenzene is this one. You have to first convert. This is the correct way. I am writing down it here. You have to first convert aniline into, it will react with HNO2 to form at 0 degree Celsius. NNO2 plus HCl or HNO2 0 degree Celsius. You will have this one, N2 plus Cl minus. This is diazonium salt. You can use that NNO2 plus HCl here. At 0 degree Celsius, you will have this one. And from this one, if you use HBF4, you will have fluorobenzene F, and then here you will have N2 plus HF, HCl plus BF3. So this is the way in which you will prepare fluorobenzene. All other methods are definitely wrong. Direct fluorination will do not monobrominated product, but it will form highly brominated product, because fluorine is more reactive. So D is the correct result. The next question that was asked by JMA is question number 8. Question number 8 is, reaction of trans 2 phenyl one bromo cyclopentane on reaction with alcoholic KOH. alcoholic KOH produces. A option is 1-phenyl cyclopentane. B option is 3-phenyl cyclopentane, 4-phenyl cyclopentane, and D option is 2-phenyl cyclopentane. These are the four options given, and this was the question asked by GM 2006. The question is, reaction of trans 2-phenyl 1-bromocyclopentane. First we have to write the configuration. Cyclopentane is this one, 1-bromo and 2-phenyl. And it is told that this is transform. This is transform. So I will write the geometry here. Here we will have this one in this way. You will have HBr, and here you will have PHH. This is the transgeometry here. If you react alcoholic KOH with this one, then alcoholic KOH will result alcoholic KOH 3-phenyl. The options are given as pentene, not pentane. This is the pentene. Here pentene, and here again pentene. All are given as pentene, cyclopentene. So if you look at the options given here, it will do anti-addition. Anti-elimination of HBr will occur. If you look at the geometry here, from this side and this side, from these two position, more substituent gate will form, but you can see that here these two are present at same position. So elimination from this side will not occur, but elimination from this side will occur. Here the hydrogen present at anti position will eliminate. So the formation of product will be this one. You will have cyclopentane here, you will have pH here, and there will be one double bond here. So the correct result will be this one, where you can see that anti-elimination is favored, and that's why in presence of alcoholic KOH, this is the correct result. If you write the name of this compound, you will have answer of, you will have 1, 2, 3. This is the way in which alcoholic KOH will eliminate and form 3-phenyl cyclopentene. If you do in syn elimination of this compound, it is case of anti-elimination product. Because it is a strong base. And if we do trans, the question is telling that reaction of trans 2. So hydrogen present at trans position here, syn position, Br and Hr present at syn position, and that's why we have used anti-elimination rather than syn elimination. This is the kinetic product, because anti-product, kinetically favorable product is this one. And if you write the thermodynamically favorable product, then syn elimination can also occur, and syn elimination will lead to formation of this one, pH. So this is thermodynamically stable product. Thermodynamically favorable product. And this is just simply 1-phenyl cyclopentane. This is 3-phenyl cyclopentane. contain. So if you look at the product given here, the question is telling that with calcholic KOH, which will trans to phenyl 1-bromocyclopentane will produce which product? So if we look at the kinetically favorable product, the correct answer will be B. And if you look at the thermodynamically, here syn elimination I am doing. It is a slow process, but it is a fast process, elimination will be fast, but you should remember that if syn elimination or trans elimination it has been done, anti-elimination will be more favored, and hence 3-phenyl cyclopentane will be the major product. You can say that because that is kinetically favorable product, this will form more with higher speed, 3-phenyl cyclopentane, and this will form with lower speed. So this is the correct result. If you have been asked about thermodynamically stable product, then in this case 1-phenyl cyclopentane can be the answer, but in such cases where syn elimination or anti-elimination case is possible, then anti-elimination is preferred because it is an E2 elimination. Alcoholic KOH is a strong base which will do E2 elimination, not E1 elimination. Question number 9 is the structure of major product. The structure of major product formed in the reaction, this one, CH2Cl, I, NaCN and DNF is, A option is this one, cyanide CH2Cl, B option is iodide CH2CN, C option is CH2CN and CN, and D option is iodide cyanide, and here it is CH2CN. This was the question asked by JV in 2006. If you look at the option here, NaCN is a nucleophile. Nucleophile will do reaction easily at benzylic position. Here it can easily attack and Cl will remove. If you want to remove this one, you have to attack here, and you know that at benzene ring, at carbonobenzene ring, nucleophilic attack is very less because of electronic repulsion between pi electron cloud of benzene ring and negative charge of nucleophile. So the correct answer will be B. You cannot do nucleophilic substitution reaction on phenyl position on carbon or benzene ring. You can do it at benzylic position or other allylic position or other alkylic position. You cannot at aryl halides. At aryl halides, nucleophilic substitution is very less, so you cannot do it. Question number 10. Which of the following is correct order of decreasing SN2 reactivity? Correct order of SN2 reactivity. A option is R2CHX greater than R3CX greater than RCH2X. B option is RCH2X greater than R3CX greater than R2CHX. C option is RCH2X greater than R2CHX and greater than R3CX. And D option is R3CX greater than R2CHX and greater than RCH2X. This is the question asked by Jamie Tothan Seven. This is the question asked by Jamie Tothan Seven. Which of the following is correct order of decreasing SN2 reactivity? Which has less SN2 reactivity? If you look at the options given here, the correct answer will be C, where SN2 reactivity is simply determined by steady hindrance. Steady hindrance. If a molecule have steady hindrance, less steady hindrance means less steric hindrance means greater reactivity in SN2. In this way, you can easily say that the correct answer will be RCH2X, where less steric hindrance is present, R2CH has somewhat higher, and R3CH will have much higher steric hindrance. So the correct answer will be C. So in this way, we have solved some problems of alkyl and aryl halides that were asked by different years.